Okay, so 7:30 a.m., day one, going to meet everybody at the apartment. Can I say the opening of the show? Can that be my voice? If we record that right now? Okay, I'm just going to do it, and then if you don't like it, whatever. Five aspiring actors taken from around the United States to come to New York City and see if they have what it takes to make it in show business. This is Makin It. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Jeez. Oh my god! There's a young boy and his dog.
Ronnie.
Darn it. Georgia. Hey, down here. Kirsten.
I'm here for movie audition, Jumba.
I've never been away from home before, so I'm excited to be here.
Fuck, I am so happy to be back in New York.
So excited. It's the biggest city where all the famous people are. I'm just so excited.
I mean, like, I mostly know about New York from, you know, like, from, like, 9/11 footage and, like, Friends.
How about a drink? Can we stop? Oh, look! There's a bar right there.
It's not my fault you're having a goddamn midlife crisis.
I'm really happy to be here. I'm really excited. I'm really excited to be here.
I am so fucking excited about this thing.
My name is Ronnie. I am 22 years old, and I'm from Pleasantville, New York. Oh my god. Oh my god. Are you guys serious? When I first walked in here, I was blown away. I really was. I walked in and the space was beautiful. I mean, it was perfect. If you asked me to design my dream apartment, this would be it. The decorating would be completely different. I would probably have carpet, you know, just kind of get some different shades and things like that. Basically blow that all up, redo it. But the general shape and size of the apartment was perfect. I couldn't ask for anything better.
Hi, I'm Georgia. I'm 19 years old and I'm from Texas.
Hi. It's okay, it's dead. Oh. I'm Ronnie.
I've never done an interview before.
Nice to meet you.
Oh my god, how awesome is this place?
Yeah, it's crazy.
I like that.
There's like, colored light and like, there's like lights really close to my face.
I'm freaking out though. Let me show you around. Come on.
Okay.
My name is Dorothy. I'm 50. I'm from Detroit. What?
Fuck.
The apartment's fucking awesome.
I got it. Right?
There's lots of
what
animals.
The fuck is this? Those animals I could do without. Oh my god, this place is unreal.
Taxidermy is when you kill an animal for science and then you stuff it for show.
I speak my language, Maninka.
Yes. Ronnie.
Jumba.
I knew it.
Hi, I'm Kirsten, and I'm 12 years old, and I'm from Los Angeles. Right after I signed up for this, I got casted for a feature film, a real movie. And so I have an agent, so I don't really know what I'm doing here, but I'm willing to take the opportunity and it will just still look good for me and my brand.
Hi, I'm Ronnie.
Hi, I'm Kirsten.
You're a little nut, a little nugget.
Kirsten.
You're a fucking kid.
Okay, so we are all here now.
Yeah.
Just for today, I'm gonna sort of
you know, try to play the role of the leader and, you know, just lead a, not leader, I'm just leading a group discussion. Now there's three rooms, two of them have two beds, one of them is a single. I put my stuff in the single because I got here first. Sorry, that's the way it is, but so I'll be in the single room for the remainder of the show. Now we gotta decide who is in the other rooms. So I know you two.
I think I need the single room because I'm a minor, so I'm not legally allowed to stay with any of you.
Yeah, but what if I got here first?
It's legal stuff.
I mean, I did get here first, though, so I don't know if that overrides legal. So you have to stay, and the producers told you that.
Yeah. So if you don't mind.
When I met Kirsten, you know, she was just sort of, you know, she's small. You can tell that that she might have health problems, that she might not, you know, make it as far as we have, you know, in life or just age-wise. Okay, in that case, you know, I'll move all my stuff out of there in a jiff, and I'll just move it right in with my new roommate, Juma. And then you can stay in the single forever, for fucking ever. It'll be great, right? That'll be really good for you.
Thanks for understanding, so thanks.
Great! All done? Let's get drunk.
Oh my goodness, look at it all. Were you gonna be our little bartender?
Nslandi nyare ma kama sura nyam mati subosu lan nyam mati aldi akosko do sim fena masura na donc au slime na.
Have a real drink. And what about you, Kirsten?
It's Kirsten. The I comes before the R. Kirsten.
Oh. Okay, what the fuck? I don't care. What do you want, Kirsten?
Oh, I don't drink alcohol. I'm only 12.
When I was 12, I was leading discussion groups in AA.
There's cameras around, and I...
They don't care. None of these people
I don't feel comfortable drinking anything besides water or something.
Oh, that's okay.
Don't feel comfortable drinking.
You know, hey, but Jambalaya, get over here.
I'm gonna make a phone call. Be right back.
Okay. Come back, sis.
Yeah. What do you want to drink?
Why are we here?
Whoa. Juma with the bombshell. That's a pretty deep question for, you know, so early in the evening, but might as well address it, right? Why are we here, you know? Do you believe in God?
No, David, shut your fat mouth and listen to me. I am not staying in this hellhole. This is bullshit, David. No, these people are fucking retarded.
It's just that, like, there's some things about, you know, Catholicism that I disagree with.
No, I'm not fucking homesick. I don't miss my mom and my dad. I'm agent sick. That's what I am. I have a shit agent that makes me want to vomit.
Well, what do you think, Juma?
I don't know why we're here.
I think that's the best answer.
You get me off of the show by the end of this week, or I swear to God I will decapitate you. And you'll never work in this industry again because you won't have a fucking head!
We play Truth or Dare? Oh. Upside down! Upside down! Upside down! Upside down! Upside down!
I can't do it!
Fucking problem!
All the blood's inside my brain now.
Oh my God.
Okay, you ready? I got a dare for you.
Okay.
I want you two guys to kiss.
No.
Yeah.
No, I have a friend.
No.
I don't care. Come on, kiss. I'm not listening. I don't hear what you're saying. La 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 la. Kiss.
Stop it.
So why do you have to do that? I mean, it's touching now, huh? Can I have my hat, please, George?
So mean.
man, what a buzzkill.
Now can I go to bed?
I'll fucking go to bed, who cares? Stay here and get drunk.
Primarily what we do here is screen acting. We do not teach stage acting here. We have technology here which puts people in a medium shot on camera, and we try to work with them to try to grapple with getting a good performance. We can do multi-camera shoots here, so somebody will sit in the control room and do live cutting, sort of like they do in a sitcom or a daytime television. As a camera goes closer and closer, audiences care less and less what an actor is saying, and they care more and more who an actor is. And in my view, and in Stonestreet's view, it's the actor that's prominent. People watch movies because of the characters. One way you learn about an actor is you just talk to them. Another way is you have them do a monologue. I'm just gonna meet them for the first time giving a monologue, so that's how I will learn about them. And that'll be my first introduction to them, which is very, very typical of the business.
Okay. I'm faster than you, you son of a bitch. I saw you coming, you piece of shit cocksucker. I'm standing here. You make the move. You make the move. You make the move. It's your move. Don't try it, you fuck. You talking to me? You talking to me? You talking to me? I'm the one that's standing here. Who the fuck do you think you're talking to? Oh yeah? Bang, you're dead. You piece of shit. You talking to me? You talking to me?
Okay, so here's the problem. I don't know who you're talking to, and I have no idea what this is about.
I fucking killed it. My monologue. That was the best I ever did.
You're going to reproach me, Stella. Stella, I just know that you're bound to reproach me. But before you do, I would like you to take into consideration that you left and I stayed and struggled. And I don't mean this in any kind of reproachful way, but all the burden descended on my shoulders. The loss. The loss.
Okay, so the best part of that monologue was when you lost your lines. So let's sort of try to make it less rehearsed. It feels like it's rehearsed.
It feels really accurately. Embarrassing, I'm sorry.
Sometimes a day goes by, one whole entire day, when I don't think of her. 24 hours pass, I look around and find that I haven't thought of her, not even when we're somewhere we used to go, not even if that's someone we used to know. It's hardly every day, it's most unusual, in fact, I can't remember when, but sometimes a day goes by when I don't think of her till morning comes, and then there she is again. Shut up, come on. No, yes.
So, thank you. So, let's talk about what was surprising about that. He sang a song, this is a screen acting conservatory.
No,
and
I try.
And you should be acting, not
singing. No. I just want to cut you off only because I feel like I know exactly what you're going to say. Doing that monologue kind of changed things for me because I realized that, you know, from this point on, I shouldn't do songs, that people aren't ready for that yet as far as acting teachers go. I think that's something that has a place in the future once once the collective acting teacher mind has really opened up to new ideas and realizing that songs are also monologues.
Hello.
Hello. What's your name?
Kirsten.
Kirsten?
Kirsten.
Okay. So what are you doing, Kirsten?
I'm doing a monologue.
Yeah, I know that. But who are you and where are you?
Oh, I'm Cinderella. I have very little to tell you. I have little to tell because I didn't go to the ball. Yes, my work was complete, and my dress was so lovely, but it was torn and thrown into the
mire. So can we start over? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Can we just tell me where you are?
Oh,
you're telling a secret to your friend, right?
Yeah.
I think she was fucking full of shit. The whole time she was doing her monologue, shit was falling out of her mouth.
Is there a next?
Thank you.
Go.
What did she get your butt up?
Come on, go. All right, so what's your name? You don't have a name?
Juma.
Juma, that's your name. Okay, Juma. So what are you doing for me?
Malonye yam kumena. Ye. Ye kuma
do fun. Do you speak English?
Juma.
Malon ala television ko ne a course sudi. Malon fene alina ndi kumena ya. Donc on cela netanya rerema. 2 days, they come to me, take me from my home, and me don't know why me I'm here. Someone, maybe a police, maybe tell me why I'm here. I don't know where I am. I don't know. Please, someone, maybe anyone. Please tell me why I'm here, please.
I feel like he tried to trick us, you know, those first couple of days he was very quiet and, you know, then he just does his monologue and he just whips it out, you know, and you're just like. Well, it's, you know, it's a song and it's kind of like about, like, you know, really like missing a girl, you know, and like there's like this girl that you miss and there's like this one day that you don't think of her or whatever.
Is there someone special for you?
I mean, yeah, you know, and obviously it was like this girl in the song, and so for me, I just made it my. It my girlfriend from back home.
Your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Your girlfriend from back home.
Mm-hmm.
What's her name?
Her name is Mary Ellen. Back home, I do have a girlfriend. I do have one. And she is just the light of my life. And I'm in love with her, you know? And she's super hot and I love her boobs. I just, they make me feel sexy and good. I don't know, me personally, I haven't dealt with a lot of African-American actors because where I'm from is a very non-African part
either.
Of Westchester. What's lucky for you is that like when you're a little kid, it matters like a lot more just like, you know, what you look like rather than like, you know, how talented you are or like how much innate acting ability like you have. So you can get those kind of roles and like, that's like cool, on you, you know, that's great.
Great.
I think you'll find that as you move on, you know, that's kind of where they separate the strong from the weak, you know, when you start getting some real scenes and things like that. So we'll see. We'll see how you do.
This is bullshit.
How long has it been?
It feels like days. I gotta tell you something. I'm doing 5 more minutes and then I'm out of here.
You're gonna just
How do you?
Yeah,
this is like
I mean,
a first
this is
class.
Bullshit. I'm not sitting around here.
Class?
The guy's a fuck.
Yeah, right. Lieutenant Langdon, I'm really glad to have you as part of the team.
Well, it's an honor to be here.
Well, you know, it's kind of common knowledge that you are a gay, that is to say, homosexual man. And I just want to say up front that I have absolutely no problem with that.
I don't have any problem with pussies, as long as they stay out of my face.
$19.99. If you're gonna tangle with Busey, you better bring your A game. That's for sure. It was a good year. Lots of work. Playboy Mansion. CAA. Some good days. But enough about me. Welcome to Stonestreet. This is a painful process. The odds that you're gonna make it are very slim. You will probably fucking fail! Because it's a cruel business. And the people out in LA are shit. A bunch of nasty fuckers. All I give a fuck about is money. I give a fuck about quality. Is there anyone here who wants to fucking suck?
I can tell that he's gonna be a no BS kind of teacher, and that's fine because I'm a no BS kind of actor. And if he wants to get tough with me, if he wants to get rough with me and roll, you know, that's fine. I'm fine with that.
Does anyone know how many people are in Screen Actors Guild, also known as SAG? Do you guys know? 110,000 dues-paying members. That's not counting the people in AFTRA, or the people in Actors Equity, or the people waiting fucking tables until they're ready to kill the people they live with. Of course, I never had to wait tables. Because when I started out, I kicked fucking ass. 1982, 1999, I kicked ass! I worked with some incredible people. Louis Gossett Jr. I worked with, he was awesome. Dan Aykroyd, Bill Murray. River Phoenix was in a movie I did, he was awesome. Leonardo DiCaprio used to shop at the same Ralph's. If you get in movies, people will want to fuck you. Just because you're on the movies, because you're on the screen, they'll see you and go, I saw that person on the screen, I want to fuck that person. Do you think I want to be fucking teaching you? I want to be fucking starring with De Niro. I want to be in fucking Avatar, not Sam Worthingham or whatever the fuck that guy's name is. But I guarantee you, by the time I'm done, stop talking out there, please. I'm gonna change your life. Question number one, is there anybody here who thinks that some kind of cosmic, nefarious fucking mistake has been made? And that you shouldn't be here? And that you don't belong here? See this? La puerta. La porte. The door. You may get the fuck out. If you don't think you belong here. And we will find out if you belong here or not. You're gonna write down every fucking thing I say. You're gonna learn everything I say. You are going to breathe and eat and shit everything that I say. And then you're gonna learn it. You're gonna live it. You are going to. Let's get started.